Good morning, everyone. This week, I'm going to be showing you every time I read, and you can see how much I read in a week. So that's what I'm reading. I'm going to go ahead and insert the clips that I got yesterday of me reading, so. The book I'm reading now is the third book doesn't come out until August, and I'm getting the second book on Wednesday. It's about this girl. She inherits this house and stuff from this billionaire that she never even met or knew, and then the family obviously thinks that she did something to get the house. I don't know, 75% away there. I made coffee. It's really. This is my bunny. His name is Beans. That is my cello. This is crazy. Libby is Avery's sister, stepsister, whatever it's called. Her abusive ex-boyfriend somehow got into this secured place and he was the one trying to kill her. Oh my word. Like, I understand, like, he was like, he's out of his mind. I feel like this is set up. Like, maybe not set up, but like, I just don't feel like he had enough reasons to want to kill her. Oh, but maybe, because if she does, Libby gets the inheritance, I think. And if Drake can get back together with Libby, like convince her to get back together with him, then he can get some of the money. I am so confused. Crazy. This is crazy. Okay. So the book just said, there are so many layers to that sentence, I couldn't begin to untangle them. The first thing that I thought of when I heard layers was from onions, from Shrek. Oh, layers, onions, Shrek, obviously. Anyways. I did some chores after I had read, and I'm gonna read for a couple minutes, like 9 minutes, before I have to practice my cello at 3. I have one more chapter left in the book until I get to the epilogue, and I want to finish it so bad. I don't think I'm ready to finish reading it yet. Okay, I'm gonna read it now. I finished the book. That was a 5-star book. That is crazy. I can't wait till Wednesday when I get the second book. See you guys tomorrow. Hello everyone. I have not read it at all today. I don't want to start anything, and I didn't really feel like reading a classic right now. I wanted something a little bit more fast-paced. I'm gonna go practice my cello for like an hour, and then I might come back in here and read until my parents get home. It came today. It came a day early. So I'm packing up the cello, and I'm about to go. I'm gonna start it. First things first, a bookmark. Now, we need to get some coffee. This Myrtle Beach cup. We got the coffee. Here's the creamer. Ice. Let's get started.
I'm on chapter 18. And we just found out. Okay, Tobias Hawthorne II, so the billionaire's son, is adopted. And he is Avery's dad. Crazy. I'm gonna keep reading. Hello everyone. I'm currently waiting for my lunch to finish. I just put a pizza in the oven and it's waiting. I get like 20 minutes until it's done. Pizza's still in the oven and I decided to make some sweet tea, so it's on the stove right now. I'm just waiting for my pizza because a tea takes a while to boil and all that. So I just wanted to tell y'all. Okay, I'm about to start reading and I'm on chapter 30. I'm reading in the kitchen because I'm keeping an eye on the tea. To do today, so I can just read this, but I'm almost done with it. Oh no. I just finished the book. Now it's time to put it on the shelf, the bookshelf. So once they're read, they get to move on. I picked out three that I really want to read, and I'm gonna decide with you guys. Okay, so the first book that I have picked out over here is this one. It's Nicholas Sparks' Safe Haven. It is 340 pages. So this is the first option. The first sentence is, as Katie wound her way among the tables, a breeze from the Atlantic rippled through her hair. The second one is The Time Traveler's Wife by Audrey Niffenegger. It's kind of a thick one. 531 pages, so it's kind of a lot. I read the prologue and then the chapter one. So the first sentence of the prologue is, it's hard being left behind. That's the first sentence. I was about to keep reading, but that's the first sentence from chapter one. It's, the library is cool and smells like carpet cleaner, although all I can see is marble. It's where the crawdads sing by Delia Owens. So there's a prologue in this one too, so I'm gonna read both sentences. The prologue says, marsh is not swamp. And then the chapter says, the morning burned so August hot, the marsh's moist breath hung the oaks and pines with fog. That's the problem. I don't know which one I want to read. Oh, I didn't tell you how many pages are in this one. Let's check. 368. I could probably finish this one pretty quickly, so I think I'm gonna go with this one. I picked out my book. I'll get back to you guys when I'm reading. I'm going to go read outside. Just drop the book. Feels really, really nice outside. I've been watching my brother like all day, my little brother, and we like played and watched some TV and stuff, and so I'm about to read now because he's taking a nap right now. I'm probably going to read later tonight, but I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. So thanks for watching. Please like, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.